How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to another episode of SevTech Ages. Today, what I want to do is get our Tinker's Construct smeltery up and running. And to do that, we need to go to the Betweenlands. And to get there, we need to go find a swamp biome that hopefully has a druid circle in it. So I'm going to have to explore a little bit. I don't think I've seen a swamp biome yet, but I am going to be heading off in the direction that our dark oak forest was. But before we go that way, there are a couple things I want to craft. So I want to get our wool going so that I can craft a vanilla bed as well as the paper as well. Because with the Tinker's Construct stuff, I would like to make paper tools. Right now, it's not going to be super good, but I'm kind of hoping by unlocking the bigger smeltery, we get access to being able to make obsidian in the smelter. Because if we're able to do that, then with our paper tools, we're able to make an unbreakable tool. So that's kind of what I want to try and get done today. So to try and make our exploration a little easier on ourselves right now, I'm going to make these. Hopefully they work the same as the slime ones here. If they don't, then I just wasted my time there. But we're going to get this thing going. Actually, that's not the right recipe. Hold on. We want the slime thingamabobber, this guy right here. So we need one block, and then we can just click on this again, do this, and give us the slime sling. So now with that, I'm hoping that the boots work, like I said. If they don't, then I need to make the slime variant. But with this, we can fling ourselves, and we shouldn't take any fall damage, and we don't. Look at that. Do they have durability? Neither one of them popped up anything. Well, this is good news. We're not taking any durability damage with these things. So let's get our wool going as well. We're going to need some wicker, and then we need to turn those into blocks. And then we should be able to do this. And we only need three of them for right now. So that is going to be our bed. And then for the paper, we also need the sawdust, the glue, and we need to plop them into this thing and then mix it together. And it should plop out. Oh, that's the wrong thing. Uh-oh. Give me that back, please. Thank you. One, two, and three. And then mix it together. It's going to plop out pulp. And then with the pulp, we plop it onto our drying rack, and it should plop into paper. All right. Well, our paper is done. Let's take all of that. And now that we have that unlocked, do we have the ability to make the tinker stuff? We do not. I'm hoping that changes once we get the controller and that unlocks more tinker stuff for this age. If we can't do the paper stuff right now, then we might kind of put the tinker stuff on the back burner right now, because we have iron, and it's just as good as our bronze stuff. So maybe the durability is a little bit higher, but as far as the armor rating goes, it is the same across the board here. So I don't think I'm going to bother making iron tinker stuff. We'll just hold off, but I'm going to go ahead and start heading out toward the dark oak forest, and hopefully I can find a swamp here in a bit. Well, just on the other side of our dark oak forest is this guy right over here, and I think this is what we are looking for. So if we have the advancement pop, then I guess that's a good sign, although we just had like a ward sound. Don't quite see anything just yet, unless I'm being completely blind here. Yeah, I don't see any. Oh, never mind, I see him now. All right, hold on, one second. Let me just try and shoot you guys with some arrows here. Oh, they have magic. I don't have magic. And the bow does a lot of damage to them. Okay, yeah, you can get out of here. You can get out of here. Oh, hello. I messed up on coming over here, by the way, with our sword. It's just about broke. We got a couple more hits in it, and then I got to repair it. So I didn't pay attention when I left the house, but we've got two of these things. And only one of those, oh, actually two of those are part of the thing that we need. So is there a way to check exactly what we need? We need to craft a talisman. So does that tell me, oh no, they're back. Hold on, I didn't know you're back yet. One second. So we need to craft this thing, which looks like we only need four pieces to make the talisman. And then we plop it into the altar thing that's in the middle of the little ring there. So we have two of the four currently. So hopefully we can get the other two from these guys as well. That'd be kind of neat. Oh, we got a third piece. There we go. We got one more to go. And there we go. We got the last piece there. So let's shift all that stuff in there. It should make the talisman that we need. That's kind of neat. Do we have to interact with it? We do. Look at that. There we go. Cool. Well, let's get the portal built here. And that is pretty cool. Can I walk back out? I can. Okay. So now we have this thing right across the water from our base. And how do I... Oh, I blocked off our walkway. Oops. How do I get in here? Do I shift or I just stand in the goo? All right. There we go. Nice. We also got another advancement there. We got two of them. Oh, it opened up another branch of stuff for us to do. Look at that. That's kind of neat. Okay. So we need to find, let me look up that thing again because I forgot, but we need something that is blue. So this thing and the aqua middle gem is what we need. And we get that by finding gems and smelting it in a purifier. So we gotta go mine for that, it looks like. That is fine. I don't know what that other bar is now above our hunger, because we're losing whatever that is. The sky block looks kind of cool. It's kind of neat. We've got a shark. Or no, that's not a shark. Whatever it is, it's eating something. We got a yellow thing that away. We got some ruins that away. We got some jars over there. I don't know where we should head first. I'm going to go toward the jars real quick and just see. Maybe they're like chests, and maybe they have stuff in there. That would be kind of neat. Can I break you? I can. And it gave us, let's see, what did it give us? A termite. And a termite hurts us. Okay, that's good to know. We got something else attacking us now. We got a, whatever that is. Get away from me, please. Go away, thank you. Nothing dropped from him. I want to try and get this other jar, dang it. I keep getting knocked off and missing it. So, there we go. Oh, that was more damage than I needed. Let me do one of these. And then, can we just open it like normal? No. Or if we did, nothing came out of it. Let me break this as well. There we go. We got an item scroll. I hear like mosquitoes, man. Leave me alone. We also got this. We got lurker skin. Okay. So what does this guy do? Doesn't do anything. I can't activate it. Never mind. I am going to jump out of this biome real quick because I don't know what's giving us slowness and I don't know what that bar is above our hunger. So I want to very quickly jump out of here and see if it maybe tells us more inside of the advancement tab. Or maybe there's a book now that we unlock this area that we can read real quick. Oh, there's actually more of these advancements for the Betweenlands here. So that's kind of cool. We'll chip away at some of those here eventually. But right now with the slowness, I think it's because we're using non-Betweenlands gear inside of that dimension. So I'm going to craft up this sword and potentially the armor for that dimension once we get back in there and see if maybe that fixes our issue. Oh, we got a gecko. I saw that as one of the advancements. I guess maybe not. Hold on one second. I could have sworn there was a gecko as an advancement. There it is. We have to test it in a cage. Okay, never mind. We'll leave it there for right now. I need to find sticks, which come from bushes, which I am not seeing right now. Can I harvest this stuff? This is just sugarcane. What are we getting attacked by? A snail. Getting attacked by a snail. All right, that's cool. Are you moving that quickly? Oh, it's shooting stuff at us. Okay, Mr. Snail. Calm down. Well, I just stumbled across a spirit tree in search of these bushes, which are right here. Finally. Okay. Ow. Hello. Okay. Yeah, we don't want to be there. I don't know if that's a boss fight or if it's just the tree stabbing us. I don't know what's going on over there, but let's get away from that. We now have these things. We have one of them. Great. Okay. Oh, we have more bushes right here. Cool. I don't know how we craft that sword. We need planks. And I guess we just make a normal axe, so we can use an axe to cut this stuff down, potentially? I don't know. I thought we needed a Betweenlands thing. Oh, no, we can actually cut this stuff down. It's just very slow. So that's good. I want to try and get safe here, so if I can launch myself up on top of the tree, that would be fantastic. Nope, not in the water, please. Oh, you know what? This is making us go, like, all the way back to the beginning of the game here. So we need to take a chopping block and then chop our wood into planks. Which, you know what, I'm fine with. Although, that is not apparently what we do, because we can't... Oh, wait. Oh, yeah, okay. Weird. We just left-click on it, and it breaks the thing instead of... Or no, that's not doing it either. Why did it just give us planks? I don't know what I did, but we got planks. So there's our crafting bench. I will gladly take that. And now we need this thing to split as well, because we need two more planks to make the sword. And there we go, I guess. I don't know. It had a little countdown on the right side of the screen there, so we were left-clicking on it to actually chop it, not right-clicking like we would normally do in the overworld there. But now that we have this, do we still have slowness? We don't. If I use this guy, we also don't have slowness. What was giving us slowness then when we were in here the first time? I have absolutely no idea, but we have two more planks and a couple more of those sticks. I'm going to take this thing with us so I don't have to craft another one of those. And I guess we can also grab a couple more things of wood because I would like to get an axe going. All right, well, I got the tools going, so I'm going to head back to the portal and try and strip mine down and see if we find any of those blue gems, unless we have to go to a specific biome, because there are at least visibly, there's different types of trees and stuff, so I'm guessing those are different biomes in this area, and try and find them that way. But I'm gonna go down real quick and see if we can just strip mine for a little while. Well, I think I'm done with the Between Lands for today. We got our hands on one aqua gem, and that's all we needed for the controller. But we do have to go back in there eventually and find this guy right here, the Ring of Ascent. That is going to allow us to craft the apple here that unlocks Journey Map. So that is something that I would really like to unlock sooner or later, because I don't really like this minimap thing that we have right now. So once we go into the Twilight Forest and start getting all these other items, then we'll probably go back into the Between Lands and grab that thing as well eventually, or at least that's the plan. But for today, all we needed was this guy right here. So I think we're gonna need some of that and some of that. We're gonna also need this stuff, and that's about it, I think. Oh, also, this thing is used in the animator. It's not a thing that pops in our hand. I thought it was like a goodie bag or something, but that is not the case. So we need to smelt this guy down, and to do that, we need a purifier, and to craft the purifier, we need wood, and these guys are just smelted down, and currently there's no way for us to double it, so we only need three of these guys. So let me just plop them over here. We got a nice little automated system going here so that I can cook all my bricks, because I do have a build that I want to do today, but it requires a lot of bricks, and I don't think I have enough to do it just yet, so that's gonna be fun. Well, we're back in the Between Lands because this thing only works with swamp water. So I'm gonna plop a couple of those guys in there. We'll plop some of that in there, and then we can scoop some of the water from here. Cool. And then kablammo. All right, nice. There's our gem, and that is all we need from this place. So for right now, we are going to leave and most likely not come back for the time being. All right, anyways, now that we have that gem, we need to make some grout. And to do that, we need to plop sand, gravel, and clay into our millstone. And over time here, it'll spit out some grout. Then we got to smelt that down. It'll make the bricks. And then with that, we can make the controller. So give me a few minutes. I don't really have all that much sand, so that's pretty much all of it. I got like 10 more in my box, so we can't really make a big smeltery today, but we are going to get it up and running at least. Alrighty, well, let's go ahead and craft up this controller so that we have that. We also want to craft up the tank as well, so we need glass for that. So over here, I had a sand smelting down, and there it is right there. Cool. So I am going to have to go look for more sand because we don't have enough right now to actually build out the smallest version of this smeltery. So we need to go get more of it so I can make more of the bricks, but the rest of this can get turned into, let's see, actually we need one of these for right now, and then everything else can get turned into the blocks, so that way we can see, yeah, we have enough for one bottom bit and then not enough to finish off the sides. So I do need to go get more sand, and I don't know if I've seen a desert. I'm pretty sure I haven't, but there are some beaches, so I'm gonna go strip some sand out from the world here, and hopefully we have enough to at least get the small version of this thing put together today. Alrighty, well, I have a couple stacks of the bricks put together. I also have some left over if I need more, but this little area right here is where our smeltery is going to be. So that's going to be the centerpiece, so let's plop that there. And then the whole inside here from this point back is going to be the smeltery area. So I'm gonna knock all this stuff out real quick. And with the bottom in place here, I'm gonna knock out this one and this one. And that is going to be both of our drains. So let's plop that there and there. Later on, if we need to have like mass production of blocks, then I'm gonna change out one of the sides for that. But right now, we're just gonna have two of these guys here. And then all we got left to do is fill in these sides here so that we can actually have this thing completed. So I'm going to cheap out on the corners here just for the sake of saving some blocks. And then on this side, I am going to, can I knock out this one and put the lava there, or do I have to place it on the other side, or the like the center bit? Nope, it looks like it's working, and it is indeed. Nice. And that's pretty much as big as our smeltery is going to get. The rest of this is all going to just be like a facade, pretty much, to make it look bigger than it actually is, but it's not actually going to be usable on this side here. Well, it looks like I didn't gather up enough sand to finish off our smeltery today, so I will do this in between episodes. We're not going to go any higher than that block there. So that's only 7 tall. It should have plenty enough room to smelt everything down that we're going to want to throw at it, so that's going to be nice. We currently have a capacity of 1,344 ingots, so that is is a lot of stuff able to go in there right now. But the next thing that we're going to do is actually change out this floor. And with the floor in place, we're now going to do as much of the walls as we can. We don't have very many bricks, and we're going to need a lot to do the entire thing like I wanted to. So this is something else that I'm probably going to have to chip away at in between episodes. But we're going to be using the dark bricks. And then on top of that, we'll have the kiln slabs, because I think it looks pretty good together. And then I'm going to wrap the whole thing real quick, as much as we can do at least with the stacks that we have. So hopefully we can get at least half of this thing done. Alrighty, well, I just about had enough bricks to finish off the entire build today, so that's good. I didn't think I had that much, but we're only missing maybe a stack or two, and then the whole backside here is done. But since we have stuff working now, I would like to get some of the Tinker's Construct stuff going, mainly the buckets. So we're gonna have to make a cast to do that. We also have to use a stone bucket to make the bucket, so that's fine. We can burn both of our clay buckets on bringing some lava over to the furnace now, so we can actually use it. But we have two options to make a cast. We can either use gold or molten aluminum, but we don't have aluminum right now. That's still not available in this age, so we can't actually do that. We have to do the gold one, which isn't that bad for us because I've already found a couple deposits of gold as well as iron and lapis, since those are new things in this age. So all I gotta do is go mine some of it, so that shouldn't be that big of an issue. I'm gonna go gather some of that right now. But before we do that, let me see real quick. Do we have access to the paper tools yet? We don't. I was hoping that when we placed this thing down, it triggered the advancement and then it unlocked those tools, but it didn't. So you know what? I'm going to do these ones real quick because these are also part of Tinkers. And maybe when we do the part maker, potentially, it unlocks the ability to make the paper tools. This should pop all of our advancements, and there we go. So now with all of that done, do we have access to the paper stuff? We once again do not. That kind of stinks. I'm actually going to just test it and see whether or not we do, because now that we have all this stuff down, we might be able to craft it. It's just not showing up in JEI for some reason. Well, it looks like we either unlock paper tools in another age, or we just don't have them available in this pack. So right now we're gonna hold off on making anything Tinkers-wise until maybe the next age, so we can see whether or not that's actually going to be a thing or not. But right now we need to craft up a new dowsing rod, and we're also going to craft up the market. I don't know what exactly we get from this. Oh, it also consumed the flute. I didn't think it would use that. And for right now, let's just go ahead and plop our market guy down right here. That is very, very loud. Oh my goodness. So that's the same kind of market that was in a skyblock, I think, or maybe Project Ozone or something like that. I don't remember where it was from. But inside of here, we have a whole bunch of saplings, and we have some Shoggoth flesh, some bone meal, a bunch of seeds as well. So that's pretty cool. I don't think we need any of these seeds other than the melons. We have pretty much everything else. So I'm just going to go ahead and go gather up some of the iron and gold real quick so we can at least get the bucket going. I got two stacks of both items here. So let's start smelting down the gold first, because that's the most important thing right now to get the cast up and running. And that is melting down very quickly. That is nice. So there's a couple things that we want to make. We want to make a bucket, so let's get that put together. And we're also going to want to make the compass. So we're going to need at least one iron arrowhead as well as four of the plates. So for that, we can cast a thing for that as well. So in our workbench here, we can set it to the arrow, and then we should be able to make it out of cobble. There we go. I also have a plate here that I'm hopefully going to be able to cast into the gold thing as well here. So we'll try all three of these things. Hopefully they all work. Nice. We got all three of them cast here, and we got our iron ready to go. So let's get our bucket. And I think I'm just going to do one bucket for right now. We might want to get more of them later, but for the time being, one of them should be fine. We can grab lava and it's not going to break the bucket. So that should be nice. And there's that. Let's also get our iron arrowhead done, and then we can do the four plates as well. This is going to help speed up the whole process getting plates, because now we don't have to do the sledgehammer thing that we had to do at the beginning of the game here. So I got all the stuff we need for the compass, so let's craft that thing now. And is this something that I have to keep on us? It sure is, and it shows us our coordinates now. That is very nice. All right, so we'll leave that in our inventory. Oh, it also pops up on our screen there on the top left. Does it show when we don't have it? No, it does not. Dang it. But at least we don't have to have that on our hotbar, so I'm fine with that. Alrighty, well, since we have the gold on hand, I'm going to make as many of these casts as I can, just so that we have them on hand, ready to go when we do want to start making some better gear. I got most of the casts made, so let's take our tool station real quick and actually upgrade it into the next stage of it, which is the tool forge. And now we should have pretty much everything in here to be crafted. What I want to do is actually make this guy right here, the excavator. It's going to be a bigger shovel for us to, like, mine up a bunch more sand at once instead of doing one by one or doing the little torch thing. So I'm going to throw one of these together real quick. It's not going to be the greatest that it could potentially be right now, but that's fine because, again, the goal is to have all paper tools. So right now with Tinker's Right, you want to have like a mix of materials because each one of them give you a different thing, which right now it doesn't tell you in the JEI thing, but if I had the booklet on me, it would tell you like the wood allows for, I want to say it regens on its own because it tells you right there ecological, but it doesn't tell you what it does. So trying to go off the top of my head here what these things do, but I don't really remember all that much, to be honest. So we're just going to stick with iron for right now, and we're probably not going to have this thing for very long. So I just want to get this thing put together, go mine some sand, and actually finish off our build today instead of delaying it till next episode. Alrighty, well, unfortunately, I am actually out of time for today's episode, so I got a little bit more of the bricks put together, but I don't think it's going to be enough to actually finish this thing because we only had half a stack, and it takes around 27 just for that front half there. So, yeah. I'm going to go ahead and just knock this out in between episodes. I have another batch of grout getting ground down right now, and I also have some more clay for the bricks on the outside here that I've just not smelted down yet because it does still take a little time to go, and I just don't have the time to sit here and let it all smelt down. So let's just finish off this back half here, and then that's going to be it for today's episode. Next episode, we are going to be messing around with the astral sorcery stuff. So I'm going to try and get a little build or something put together for that thing as well, just so that it's not just some random thing sitting on the ground here and it looks somewhat decent. But yeah, that's where we're going to be wrapping up today's episode. So I hope you guys enjoyed as always, and I will catch you in the next one. Thanks for watching.